student, licensed practical nursing student at Lincoln Tech in Rhode Island. So this video is going to explain about six ways to get through this program or any LPN program out there. I know that you guys can do it, so please continue watching. Right now, I graduate in 4 months. I got one mod left. Woo! I've been getting through this program with B pluses, A's, so my tips can really help you. So just look forward to the tips and keep watching.
If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night.
Tip number one. Okay, so tip one, all jokes aside, God. You need God. You need Jesus. Not Jesus, not Robert, Jesus. Yes. Why? Because you put your faith in him, he would get you through anything. You know, he would walk you through. It's very stressful. It's high demand. You know, you have a big stress level on your shoulder, you know, and you need to put your faith in God because he would get you through when you're feeling down. You pray, whatever it takes. God. I'm not playing. God. With a little bit of LPN, but God. All right. Tip two. You need to set goals. Set goals. And what I mean, you can do daily goals. You can do monthly goals. You can do 5-minute goals, you know. And some goals that I set, it can be simple as, okay, today's Monday. I have med surg, so I'm going to stay an hour after school more than I usually do. That's a goal, hey. But when you set these goals, you really have to stick through them, because then the following week and the week after that, you'll see that things start to come at an ease, and you know, you come with this schedule, and it comes to you, and it's much easier. Tip number three, already halfway through. Have confidence. If you don't have confidence, exit out this video. Seriously, joking. Because you know what? I can do a video on how I gain my confidence. So you can, if you want to in the link, you can comment below and let me know if you want some hints on what boosted my confidence. One, I'll let you in. I walked in like, I will be a nurse. I will get this program. And I've been keeping this attitude for these 9 months that I've been in these programs. I got 4 months left. And I always told myself, listen, I will be a nurse. I will pass my exams. And if you have that mindset, you're foreshadowing your future. So you're going to, that's what you're going to do. You know, that's what you're going to achieve. So have confidence, be positive, optimistic. You know, and carry yourself well, you know, approach things as if you've been here before. You know, it's okay not to know, but hold that title when you do know. Tip number four. Use your resources, and your resources, your number one resource is your books. Seriously. But your instructors, those are your big resources. If you're not asking questions and you're not keeping up to date with things, then you're just like a little lost puppy. So make sure you have a connection with your instructors, your classmates. That's like the biggest resource there. You know, look around your surroundings in class, and you can point out those students who's taking it serious compared to those who's, you know, I'm just here because it's where I ended up, you know. But at the same time, look at everyone as, everyone has strengths. You know, you can be so smart in, let's say, you can be smart in your med surg, your fundamentals course, whatever, and then you can fail on at your clinical site, but somebody has different techniques that you can use, you know. So just because you're good in one subject doesn't mean, and just because you're good in one subject and someone isn't as good as you, doesn't mean that they won't be better than you in the next subject. So keep your classmates, keep them close, very close. You can utilize them. Those are resources, you know. Make study groups. I have another video about my little study groups that I love. You know, we become a family. So those are big resources there. Tip number five, we're almost done, okay? Time management. Oh my God. America runs on Duncan. No, America runs on nursing. Okay. Because like you just live for nursing. Like everything you do, your whole life is just nursing school, study. I have to do this. I have to do that. You know, everyone has a life, you know, I have a kid, you know, and I'm still managing. I'm doing really well. So time managing, is very important. You know, you have to prioritize and know that, listen, studying, comes before anything. You know, you have to find that time to study. Work, forget it. Save money before you come into the program, because if you think that you're going to still be working your 32, 40 hours, even an 8-hour shift a week can bring you back, because that time that you're working, you can actually be studying. Like, I'm per diem, and I do like every other weekend, and when it's time for me to go in for work, I just be sitting in bed like, oh my god, I could be studying right now. Like, what am I doing here? The whole time at work, I'm just like, oh my god, what do I need to do on my exam? I need to be studying. I'll go sneak in a break room and just read my books. Like, so time management, put all your time into studying and reading those books. Our last tip, I'm sorry, it's done. Our last tip, you have to become selfish. And me, I'm not that type of person. Like, being selfish, like, you know, I like to be selfless. You got to be selfless, you know, and like, but nursing school requires you to be selfish. Why? Because you need to learn how to say no. No. Oh, Torin, can you go out for a drink tonight? Nope, I got to study. You know, Torin, can you babysit your niece? Oh, no. Got to study, you know? So you're not going to have time for your family, your friends. If you're in a relationship, forget it. You're in a relationship with the nursing books, your clinicals, you know, that's your relationship. So becoming selfish, and I mean, because you're going to have to learn how to say no to people, and it's going to hurt. You may lose some people on the way, but it's going to be, by being selfish, you're going to get a lot done, and you're going to stay focused. And it's not a bad thing, because when you graduate and everybody who's at your graduation and applauding you and everything, they're going to see why, you know, they're going to understand why you were that way. And then you can come back to your selfless personality, you know. Some of you guys are probably already selfish, so whatever, you know, that's probably not even hard. But those are like a few like quick 6 tips. If you guys want any more videos, just let me know. I'll be more than happy. I actually did a head-to-toe assessment. Oh my god. I walked into class and they're like, oh, Torin, you got to do your head-to-toe assessment live. You have to record it and turn it in. I'm like, what? What? My hair looked horrible. Like, there were braids from like 2-3 months ago, probably from the first mod. And, you know, I don't have money in nursing school to begin my hair done. I looked horrible, so I was like, no, but I did it anyway. It came out good. There was a lot of glitches in there, a lot of mistakes, but you know, I still posted it, so check it out. The link is below. I posted it because I want to see the growth from now, what I did that assessment, to when I'm done, you know. So that's why. So you can go check it out, you know. It was some informative information there, so I'm sure you can utilize that too. But I'll be posting more videos regarding like flashcards, my study guides. Let me tell you about my study guide. One mod, people were feeling like they were feeling, and I started making these study guides, and people's like, oh my god, Torin, your study guide, you know, I was in my 70s and I got in my high 80s, almost 90s from your study guides. Can you please do another one? So we had like 3 tests left for the mod, and I totally made study guides, and mostly all of us passed the mod, and just one person failed. I'm sorry for that, but she's trooping on, you know. So I have study guides. I told you about the flashcards, different other tips, clinical tips, because I am a CNA. I work in a hospital, so I have a lot of experience, so I can give you good tips on, you know, how to be effective and efficient on the clinical floor, because there's 2 different things. You can be effective, but if you're not efficient, then what does it apply, you know? So just keep following me and watch my videos, and I'll keep you up to date. And if you have any questions, concerns, feel free to comment below. I love constructive criticism, you know. Just support me throughout this journey, you know, and one day this can be you on the other side, and I would love to follow you. So I look forward to hearing from you guys, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.